Hello everyone, welcome to Film Family, and today we're actually going to be talking about some non-film things. We're going to be talking about E3, which is obviously the big video game event convention, and we're going to be talking about some of our favorite trailers and what we're expecting to see out of some of these cool new games. And yeah, if this is something that you like, you know, leave down below if you want to see us do it more in the future. You know, we're not just big fans of movies, we like TV and video games and all kinds of stuff like that. So yeah, what would you guys say your favorite trailer is?
Halo. I didn't know they were making Halo, and I love the Halo franchises.
Yeah, for me, I don't think there was one game that quite excited me quite as much as Call of Duty did. And I know a lot of people might laugh at that because they say it's Call of Duty the same thing every year. And I would be inclined to agree, except that it's Modern Warfare. And the three Modern Warfare games have been three of the absolute best Call of Duty games. That's the first Call of Duty I played.
But they've also been pretty much the same thing. But
they're just three fantastic games, from their multiplayer to their campaigns, their cinematic, and just how good they are. And I'm just excited to play another Call of Duty game. If I see Captain Price back, I might just lose it, because one of the greatest video game characters of all time. And I have so many fond memories with the Modern Warfare games. All three of us used to play Modern Warfare 3 together. So, you know, I think that's one that excites me. But there's also some that I'm curious about. Deathloop, that Taj just showed us that trailer. That's what I'm pretty interested to see more about. It is Bethesda, who made Skyrim, who is probably one of the greatest games I've ever played. So I'm pretty excited for that. And also Elden Ring. I think that game has a lot of potential. And, you know, I'm excited to see where they go with it.
Yeah, see, I'm worried that Elden Ring is going to be more of a RPG game, but not like Skyrim. I think it's going to be more of something where I throw down a card that does 70 damage, and then, you know, like some really bad stuff like that.
Why don't we explain what it is? Because I don't think they...
Well, unfortunately...
I don't know what it... All I saw was a trailer.
No, but who's behind it?
Well, it's George R. R. Martin, and I unfortunately can't remember his name at the moment, but he's, I think, a Japanese video game developer, and he's developed some popular games before, and so they decided to kind of create this world together. George R. R. Martin, if you don't know, he wrote the books that Game of Thrones are based off on, Song of Ice and Fire. So, you know, I think that's a game that has a lot of potential. I think the game that had the most hype going to this by far was Cyberpunk. It's a game that's been talked about for, I mean, almost 2 or 3 years now. And, you know, people have just been waiting for updates, and it finally has, you know, it's been shown information about it. It was a game at first. I'm not really into whole cyberpunk like type of worlds and things like that. It's just kind of like, I don't know, uninteresting to me. But it looks like a promising game. They got Keanu Reeves in it, you know, who's obviously really cool. And it just looks like a really, you know, if it's done right, it looks like it could be a very creative and just vivid and rich world that you can explore. I'm a big fan of open world games. So
yeah. And the Keanu being in it was pretty much a surprise of E3, and it kind of it trended on Twitter and stuff like that. So that was kind of cool as well. I haven't played Breath of the Wild, but my wife has, and she loves that game, and she was really excited to hear that there's a sequel. I mean, extremely excited.
It's a very popular game.
And I saw on the internet there was a bunch of people from IGN that they showed like their whole headquarters when it was announced, and everyone was jumping up and down. And I asked my wife, I was like, what is this? And she's like, no, you haven't played the game. You don't understand how, like, all these people were getting excited, jumping, like high fiving. And I was like, that, you know, I mean, I'm part of the nerd culture too, but I was like, but she's like, no, you don't understand. The game is
I think
is
we've
worth
all
it.
Had those moments for us.
Oh, I've always had
season
that.
7 was announced. That was
oh, my
mean.
Gosh. I've always had
but
those
But I think,
moments.
You know, I never played the Breath of the Wild either, but, you know, I was happy for people. I am happy for people when they get things that they want out of their fictional stuff.
I have to play it. I heard it's a perfect game.
Do you have a Switch?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, I have a Switch. I'm excited for the Super Mario Bros. That comes out in November. Love that game. Four players, it's so much fun.
Yeah, I mean, Super Mario, it's very iconic, and, you know, Nintendo, classic. Most people are agreeing that Nintendo had the best kind of presentation. They had the best presentation.
Xbox announced that they have a new system
coming out. Scarlet. And they're launching with Halo Infinite, which these two are definitely bigger Halo fans than I am. I didn't really grow up on Halo, but, you know, if it's a good game, I'll definitely get it. It looks pretty exciting.
I had, like, a mild form of PTSD from Halo because I played it for 24 hours straight.
Yeah, Prince
and
actually.
I was dreaming I was in war. Like, every time I'd close my eyes, I was getting shot at by aliens.
Yeah, I don't know if I've ever seen a person play a video game for any individual period of time longer than Prince played. I think it was Halo 2.
Probably 3.
Yeah, it was one of those two. He played it for, like, I'm not joking when I say, I think 16 hours straight. So, yeah, Champions he's obviously a big fan. yeah. But for me, I'm definitely excited for that. I'm excited for Modern Warfare. I think we should talk about the elephant in the room, which is the Avengers game.
Oh, yeah.
We showed
yeah.
Prince the trailer. He didn't really like it. Neither did most people. It's a trailer that there was nothing about it that really wowed me. But, you know, I was thinking about it. I feel like people are being a little ungrateful that we're getting this game just happening for me is a big deal. But more of that, I think that people are forgetting that the people who are developing this game, Eidos Montreal, they're the guys who made Arkham Asylum, like the Arkham, you know, which is still considered to be as one of the best superhero games and a groundbreaking superhero game. And, you know, if you get not just one character, because those games are awesome, but you really just play as Batman and, you know, Nightwing and whatnot. And this game, you get to play as characters with completely different skill sets, completely different powers. And, you know, for me, I'm excited. I hope it's open world to the point where you can just take Iron Man and fly around. You know, I'm most excited to play with the Hulk, but it is a game that, you know, I hope it doesn't fail. But more than that, like, I feel like people are really giving it too much criticism without saying enough.
This is my problem. Yeah. I was not blown away by the graphics on it. I thought they should have been better for the Avengers. I also think if you're going to spend the money to get the Avengers licensing, you might as well make the characters look like the people and not try to change it up.
Well, you which know, costume like, did you like?
No, not costume. I'm talking about the face.
Which like, face did you like?
The Iron Man, because I love Tony Stark and Robert Downey Jr. Well, here's did not the thing. Work.
Here's it right here. I'm gonna stop you. I'm going to stop you because he's based it off of the movies. I think that's the whole problem with this game is people are so spoiled because those movies are just so good. Those movies have their own storyline, but there's also, I think people forget, like 60-plus years of comic books that those movies are based on, and this is a different universe, it's a different story, it's not tied to the MCU, so we get a different look and, you know.
But then you can't expect the diehard fans from this MCU to just, oh my god, I love it over
those
here.
Aren't the only fans, there's also comic book fans. There's also MCU and comic book fans, newsflash, so they might like this game. For me, the only thing I really did like was Captain America's outfit. It looked a little weird to me, but I thought Hulk and Iron Man looked pretty good. I thought Thor looked pretty good. And I think if it's a good story, it should be a
I'm
good
I'm worried
game.
That they're going to have too many superheroes and they're going to force you when to jump no, through the superheroes.
I don't think they'll force... I mean, I think that will be cool sometimes if there's like a situation to solve and each person has a unique power. But I think if it's in a fight, you use who you want. It reminds me sort of a GTA 5 when you're playing a mission, you need to switch between...
Well, that's what you would hope it would
each
be.
Of the three, yeah, I'm saying, like, that's what I hope it is, kind of, where...
I would like to see person, it more like a Lego game, where you can choose when to switch,
no,
depending on
it's not trying to be that
cartoony.
Stuff.
No, not cartoony, but, like, the yeah, mechanics and usage of it would
yeah,
be
Yeah, which
nice.
Would be cool, because they each have their different kind of, you know, abilities. But I do hope it's not too of a constrained game. I hope it's open world enough. But I also hope it's not too open world. I hope there's like a guy. I think there's a good balance in there. It's hard to find, but when you find it, you get yourself a really good game. I do think this is in the same universe as Spider-Man. Nothing has really been said yet. But, you know, I think that they're going to. Plus, they said free Michael, or no Michael transactions and free DLC. We're going to get people like Hawkeye hopefully added. And, you know, everybody's asking where's Hawkeye. And so, yeah, I think that's a game that. You know, a lot of people had immense hype for it. You know, the trailer did live up to it for them, but I'm still excited for that.
Wait, let me ask you, are you excited because you know what the developers can do? Because
yeah, exactly. I mean,
and you're not excited because you based it just off of what you saw.
After
yeah.
I
but
saw,
also like I haven't seen any gameplay. Like we can say that it's in-game footage, but until I actually see gameplay, I just
yeah. See, okay, he's, see he that right there behind it.
It's
so
just
he's like
simply. That's just a bad statement to make because it literally, a lot of the parts are from in-game footage. He just wants to see people pressing buttons, which it's just, it's.
I want to know the mechanics of it. I want to know the mechanics
well, then play
of it. Otherwise, they're going to be misleading to you because all those scenes are going to be just press
Prince,
Y.
Prince actually just has, from what he was telling me before, he has PTSD from Halo Wars, which he says is a great trailer to bad game. Now, yeah, I was
very misleading. It didn't even look like the game at all. That and they said in-game footage, too, by the way, because when you zoom in, oh, the graphics are fantastic.
Well, you know, we could go into that. This video isn't about in-game footage, but I'll just say this, that, you know, I'm excited for a lot of these, you know, new games. And I think another game that that people were talking about was the Ghost of, unfortunately, I forgot the last name, but it's about the Samurai, and it's the PS4 game. And I think a lot of people are excited for that game. And that's a game that to
I'm
me
an Xbox guy. PlayStation, get out of my face. Like, I don't even want to hear that.
All right, yeah, well, I'm a little both. Said that yeah, in this yeah. video.
Mm-hmm. No, I mean, I play
I
both.
Try to make peace. That's all I am. I'm not a
I think PlayStation like has better single-player games.
I absolutely agree. Yeah. PlayStation single-player games are far better. But you know, I like Xbox's like systems more.
Yeah.
So I really controller. Think it's subjective.
And the controller.
I don't think
better.
One's objectively better, but I personally prefer Xbox. But I think in terms of single-player games and, you know, single games to that console, PS4 knocks about the water. But, you know, I think there's a lot of great games coming, and you know, I think there's a game in kind of every genre now that people can be excited for. I just want to play Elder Scrolls 6. I know there's like 3 more years till that comes out, but that's the only game I can.
Yeah, because there was Elder Scrolls Online, which was technically the 6th one, right? And then now they're coming out with an actual Elder Scrolls 6.
Pretty sure Skyrim's Elder Scrolls.
No, that's 5. Skyrim is Elder Scrolls 5, and then Elder Scrolls Online came out, and then I think they're coming out with Elder Scrolls 6.
I have no idea what I'm talking about then. I don't know.
I didn't like the last Elder Scrolls Online. I thought the story was a little weak, but it's hard because you can't do it with the multiplayer, but I want to see another Skyrim.
I just want to see, you know, I'm excited for Cyberpunk. That's definitely a game I probably will be buying if it gets good reviews. That has the potential to have that kind of
critical... I think it's going to be like a Wolfenstein.
Oh, no, I don't think so. It's going to be much bigger, more, you know, grand and open world than Wolfenstein. I think, like... A game it's more akin to is, you know, an open world game like Red Dead Redemption, which is obviously the second one came out last year. It was extremely acclaimed. And I think if it does, you know, its job right, and it has this rich, vivid world with different missions and different people and different locations, it could truly be a good game. Because I think the best thing you can get out of an open world game is different types of locations. Mm-hmm. You get urban areas, you get forest areas, snow areas, and Cyberpunk is a completely unique thing. Oh, and there's one other thing I feel like we should talk about, Jedi Fallen Order. Prince saw the gameplay for that. So, yeah, Taj, what do you think of that?
I'm really excited about it. I actually... Full disclosure now, I actually saw some of the... I don't know if I'm actually supposed to say that. When I went to see Titanfall 2, I visited the
development studio?
Yeah, and...
Respawn.
And they showed me some photos and pictures of their new project, which is this project. And so I was sworn to secrecy for all that time period. But now that it's out... No, seriously.
Yeah, no.
I know a lot more than I'm supposed to know.
Okay, well, yeah, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm super excited. I think
we all love Titanfall, right?
Titanfall is really good. Yeah. Titanfall 2 is incredible. This is obviously a different type of game, but I think I'm a big Star Wars fan. Unfortunately, you know, this isn't the exact era I would like, but I'm not gonna sit here and be picky. You know, I feel like I'm just grateful to have a Star Wars video game.
Is it like a Battlefront? What is it like?
No, it's a fully open world game
for Star Wars.
Yeah, but it takes place between A New Hope and Revenge of the Sith, and it's one of the last Jedi's.
With like the guy, not the big machines, but the guy, but because they can run on walls. Yeah,
it's not like a Titanfall. It's not a first person. Yeah, because shooter.
But also Titanfall didn't really have a campaign that much.
The second one they did. Yeah. Okay, but yeah, basically it's you know a with game with different planets, different locations, and you know even though I'm always gonna pray for one day there's gonna be a Clone Wars game that's solely dedicated to the Clone Wars era or Old Republic. But, you know, I certainly am excited for this game. I hope it gets, you know, good reviews. And, you know, I'm just excited to play an open-world Star Wars game. Yeah. I think they need to make another Middle-Earth game based on somewhere in the Lord of the Rings universe. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, it's a very cool universe. The Shadow of Mordor is very popular. So,
yeah.
I'd say that overall, you know, it's really promising games this year. There's some that, you know, let some people down. And there's also some games that we don't know a lot about that... You know, have enormous potential. So, you know, we're just gonna wait to see more, you know, news and gameplay and footage and trailers. So,
and let us know if you want to see more as well in terms of that or what games we should.
Yeah, what game excited you most to E3? You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. So overall, you know, it was pretty interesting, and I think we're excited for the future. You know, we're all pretty big video game fans. So.
And Witcher 3 is coming out for the Switch, which is something I'm excited about. I'll tell you guys more about it off the thing.
That'll be interesting.
Yeah.
All right, well, thank you, and like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
Adios.